Hello and welcome to the Justice Factor. After more than a year of insults and arguments, COSATU finally expelled its biggest affiliate, NUMSA, on Saturday morning. What happens now? NUMSA General Secretary Ivan Jim joins us today to discuss this and other issues. First, though, South Africa received yet another sovereign credit downgrade of its sovereign credit last week from ratings agency Moody's, placing us just a notch above junk status. What's happening to our economy? My guests are economist Professor Chris Malikane of Wits University and Dr. Roelof, Botha, economic advisor to PwC. Gentlemen, welcome to the show. Dr. Botha, do you agree with Moody's?
No.
Why not?
This is the same crowd that downgraded our banks a while ago when we are in fact rated number 3 in the world out of 150 countries for the soundness of our banks. If you look at the latest PwC major banks analysis.
Let's leave the banks aside. It's like you saying, I say to you, this economy is growing at 1.4%, and you're saying, oh no, but the people who are saying that are not nice people. We're still growing at 1.4%, which is miserable.
Okay, well, let's cut to the fiscal indicators. Mm-hmm. It's just that I just wanted to tell you that I don't trust these guys. because our banks are pretty sound. Yeah. Now, if you look at public finance indicators, our public debt, gross public debt GDP ratio, is under 50%. Mm-hmm. Japan's is approaching 200%.
Yes.
The US is above 100%.
Yes.
I mean, this is crazy stuff. Now, the acid test, if we can cut to the bone, the acid test for any downgrade, this credibility in the Moody's decision, and which actually just is a knee-jerk reaction.
I see you want to talk about credibility. Let's talk about credibility. Chris Malikane, Professor Chris Malikane. Now, let me ask you, these are the people who didn't foresee, for example, the financial crisis of the late 2000s. These are the people who didn't realize that, you know, America is about to implode. Do you have faith in them, as he says he doesn't have faith in them?
No, I don't have faith in these ratings agencies. However, we should be objective. Mm-hmm. South Africa's debt increased from 28% in 2008 to just less than 50%, as Roelof says, in 2013. Mm-hmm. So such a short space of time, debt has almost doubled. And South Africa's problem is the current account deficit. Mm-hmm. You know, because of that current account deficit, South Africa's foreign debt increased from $25 billion in 1994. It's now sitting at $140 billion. So this country is actually debt-driven.
If I can just complete that previous sentence of mine, the acid test for a credit downgrade is the bond yield. What I'm trying to say is that, and this is fact, is that if a ratings agency downgrades a country's debt, then the bond yield is supposed to increase because it's telling people, don't buy this country's debt.
Yes.
You know, to a certain stage. So the only way you can sell your debt is to if the yield increases. Now, what in fact happened since the previous downgrade by Fitch, mm-hmm. which Moody's just followed by a knee-jerk reaction, our bond yield dropped by 40 basis points.
So this is
terribly embarrassing for Moody's and Fitch, by the way. Really?
Do you agree with that, Chris?
But bond yields are volatile. They can drop, they can rise for other reasons than downgrades and so forth. What is important here is you need to look at the structure of the South African economy. This economy is actually running a permanent current account deficit because of foreign ownership.
There you go. This is the problem. It seems as if you're avoiding the fact that there is a problem here. And that's what Chris Malikane is saying.
The foreign ownership has got absolutely nothing to do with the current account deficit. The current account deficit is as a result of the imports of oil and machinery and equipment. That's 70% of our total imports. And without that, we don't have an economy.
Our
current account deficit GDP ratio doesn't scare me. Because if we don't have a large deficit, we don't have growth. And what Chris doesn't mention is that our financial account surplus is significantly larger than the current account deficit. So once again, that is not conducive to a downgrade.
The point he's making is that there is a deterioration every quarter in this economy for the past 4 or 5 years.
Thanks to labor unrest, yes?
No, actually the current account deficit is made up of two components. Mm. One component is the net income transfers from property, and the second component is trade account. The trade account is just 2.1% of the current account deficit. The 4% is due to the foreign outflow, the outflow of profits from this economy due to foreign ownership. So that is the issue. The current account is actually made up of these two components. The IMF has changed how the current account is measured. I don't know if Roelof knows this.
No, I know it quite well. We also have dividend inflows and interest inflows from our investments abroad. From our multinational companies.
They're just too small.
Globalization is two-way traffic. You cannot expect the rest of the world to you to invest in the rest of the world, and okay. they don't invest in you.
Guys, let me ask you this. Next month, Fitch and S&P are going through exactly the same process that Moody's has gone through now. What's your expectation, Chris Malikane?
Well, my view is that as long as the South African economy is structurally, you know, having these problems that you mentioned before, there's nothing that's going to change. The debt is going to continue rising, and there's going to be downgrades. So whether Fitch is restructuring its own way of analyzing the situation, that is not going to change the fact that the economy's debt is persistently rising because of these current account imbalances.
What are the implications of that if this goes ahead and there's another downgrade?
Well, it means that the risk premium of the country rises, the country finds it more difficult and more expensive to borrow, and that has an impact on the capacity of the state to finance its developmental programs.
Roelof, brother, you don't look convinced.
Well, you know, Chris is not talking the truth, because after the last downgrade, our bond yield declined. But in theory, he's correct. I agree with him. I'm hoping that these ratings agencies have a hard look at a couple of things like the youth wage subsidy, which has created 200,000 jobs in the space of 6 months. For every 100,000 jobs that the youth wage subsidy creates, government pockets 1 billion rand in indirect taxes. So if we grow at 3% next year, and we create 1 million jobs with the youth wage subsidy, which is probable, then we've got 39 billion
rand. One quick question for you. Right now, we're going through a week when some of us haven't had electricity in parts of the day. Unemployment is ticking up. Economy is growing at 1.4%. The debt profile of the country is looking bad. And you're telling me that I should sing Kumbaya, it's all happy.
No, I'm not saying it's all happy, but next year we've got more electricity. We've got 4,000 megawatt of renewables coming into the equation. We've got Medupi coming online next year.
Chris Malikane, you get the last word. What do you say?
If you're an investor, foreign investor, in a country that is permanently running deficits, particularly the current account deficits, whether you've got a lot of electricity or a lot of water, a lot of air, it doesn't matter. The issue is the capacity of the economy to pay back its debt. And the South African economy is increasingly finding it more difficult to pay its debt.
Professor Chris Malikane, Dr. Roelof Botha, thank you very much, both of you, for a very lively discussion. Thank you. After the break, we ask Ivan Jim why he's fighting so hard to stay in COSATU when it doesn't want him or NUMSA.